In this video, I'll cover how to build a roof for a multi-level structure and then display the roof planes on a single floor for your roof plan drawing. Let's begin with this single-story house and build the second floor. In the build menu, I'm going to come down underneath floor and build a brand new floor. I'll let the program derive the second floor from the main floor and then accept all the defaults for this floor. Since I have the automatic roofs on, the roof then follows that second floor and rebuilds. On the 2D display, the floor indicator has moved up to the second floor. I'm going to toggle on the reference display. You'll find that tool over on my right-hand side. Also, F9 on the keyboard enables that view. I'm going to take the wall. I'm going to reshape the second floor so that it's a much smaller footprint than the lower floor. We'll take the wall above the garage, slide it back. I'm going to do the same thing on the pop-out gable on the back. Let me toggle off the reference display. You can see in this 2D view, the gables from the floor below have followed up to the second floor. To remove those, I'm just going to simply grab the existing hip wall, slide it to the other end, get rid of the gable on the back. I'm going to do the exact same process on the front, slide this over, and get rid of the gable. This wall is marked as a hip wall, and that way the gable is then overridden. I'm going to build a third story back up into the build menu, come down to floor, build new floor. Again, I'm going to use all the defaults from the program to create the floor. And you can see in the 3D display, again, the roof follows that same second floor and rebuilds because the automatic roofs are on. Over in the 2D view, I'm going to toggle on the reference display, F9 on the keyboard, and you can see that it's showing the first floor outline. You can control this reference display if you wanted to show the second floor. Right now it's set up to be automatic, but you can drop this down and display any floor that you want when using this reference display tool. On the third floor, I'm going to click on the right-hand side wall, and then I'm going to slide that over so that it's parallel with the garage to create the stair-stepped three-story design. Toggle off reference display. For the third-story roof, I'm going to double-click on the left side wall. I'm going to mark this as a high shed gable wall, and then on the opposite wall, I'm going to change that back to a hip roof. I'm going to reset the pitch of this back to 3 and 12. And then the two perpendicular walls, I'll hold my shift key down and I'll toggle those to a gable and create the shed style roof. Now as I go back down to the first floor, I want to take and display all the roof panels on the first floor. There are two ways to accomplish displaying your roof planes on this main floor. One is to move the display of the roof panels down to the first floor. The second is to use reference display. Let's begin with moving the roof panels down to the first floor. The floor indicator, I'm going to move up to the second floor. I'm going to hold my shift key down. I'm going to select both roof panels, and there's an option in my lower edit menu to show on the floor below. It says display on floor below. This process will turn off the automatic roof builder. I'm going to go ahead and say yes. As you move down to the first floor, you can now see the two roof panels that we just moved down. There's no change in the 3D view. I'm going to go up to the third floor. I'm going to do the same thing. Select the roof panel, display on floor below, and then I'm going to do it one more time as I move down to the second floor. Select it, display on the floor below, and then on the first floor, you can see that it has all the roof panels that are required to build this three-story house. This is a pretty easy approach. However, it does turn off the automatic roof builder. I'm going to show you how to use reference display and accomplish the same thing. Let me go ahead and press undo a few times here. First of all, notice that my save plan view is using the roof plan. Using the reference display tool, you can click on the floor indicator to open up this dialog for reference display. Currently, it is using the reference display, which is a default out of the box, to superimpose the floor above or the floor below onto this main floor. I'm going to come over here and use the drop-down, and I'm just going to change this to the roof plan display set. And then I'm going to go ahead and click the Define button. I'm going to use this as the basis for my reference display because it has the right colors and it has a lot of the layers on that I want, but mainly the colors. So I'm just going to make a copy of this set, and I'm just going to call it the roof plan reference display. Once I've done that, I'm just going to do a little bit of turning on and off of layers. So I'm going to go ahead and select all of those layers that are turned on. And then the main things that I'm interested in, one is the roof plane. I want to display those. And two are the roof labels. So I'm going to turn these two things on. I'm going to make sure everything else is turned off. So as I slide back up, you can see the only two layers that are turned on are the roof planes and the roof labels. Now that I've created this roof plan reference display set, I'm going to change the behavior. Instead of it being automatic, so as you move up and move down between floors, it will try to intelligently figure out which floor you'd like to reference display. I'm going to turn this on for the second floor to superimpose this when I'm in this roof plan, say plan view. Let's go ahead and say OK. Then as you toggle on reference display, again that tool is either in your FAR toolbar or F9 on the keyboard will turn it on. So now I'm displaying the roof panels from the second floor over here just using reference display, and you can toggle this on and off as you press F9 on your keyboard. I'm going to add one more reference display to superimpose the third floor roof plane onto this floor. Tap on the floor indicator. I'm going to come down and I'm going to use insert above, and then I'm going to make sure that the floor is for the third floor, and we'll change it to the layer set that we just created. So the roof plan reference display, and that superimposes the third floor roof panel on the first floor. F9 on your keyboard will toggle those on and then toggle them off. You can send this view out to your layout sheet and have all of your roof planes on a single story, if that is appropriate for your construction drawings.